Welcome, beloved, once again to the Way of Salvation program. And we thank God for the opportunity to listen to the infallible word again. In the last episode, I was dealing with the role of the pastor, shepherd, and demonic oppressions. And you have understood by now that the role of the shepherd is so important because he is the one standing in between demons and the church. It must be a strong dog. That is what I spoke about in the last episode. So let's continue today to learn more from the role of the pastor and demonic activities. You see, talking about demons in the church, I want us to understand that casting out demons is not a special gift in the church. It is not a special gift in the church to cast out demons. It's not true. So you have to understand that every Christian should be able to cast out demons. Every Christian should have the authority, the power over demons. So let's look into the Word of God as we proceed. Let's look at Mark chapter 16. Mark chapter 16, verse number 17. Mark 16:17. The Lord said, it is the Lord Jesus, the Master, he said, and these signs will follow those who believe. In my name, they will cast out demons. In my name, they will cast out demons. So casting out demons is a sign. It's a sign that you are a follower of Jesus. All followers of Jesus should cast out demons to prove to the unsuspecting, the ignorant world that we have power over demons. That is the meaning. It will show them that you are truly a follower of Jesus. If you say you are a follower of Jesus and cannot have power, cannot exercise power over demons, something is wrong somewhere. Because my Bible tells me that at the mention of the name Jesus, every name, principality names, powers names, darkness, rulers in darkness names, all those names should bow in the name of Jesus to the glory of the Lord. At the mention of the name Jesus, every name should bow. So you can see that casting out demons is not a special gift. Let me go further to let you understand that every Christian should have dominion over demons. But not all can handle the categories of demonic activity. Some of them are enormously powerful. Some of them are very powerful. Talking about the principalities. So read my book. I've shared certain deeper things so that you understand certain things. What I want you to understand is that every Christian can cast out demons, but not all category of demons. You see, if you meet a principality, the most powerful and wicked ones, and if you are a weak or a baby Christian, you cannot handle that one. But you see, but if you grow, Christianity starts from babyhood to adulthood. Then you go into the mature side, you see. So that is how it is. If you are a baby Christian, you cannot handle every Christian. You cannot handle every demon. But if you are mature, prayerful, and strong, then you can handle. See? Let me give you a scenario in the Bible. When a man brought his son to the disciples in Matthew chapter 17, verse 21. The disciples by then prayed and prayed and prayed, but they couldn't cast out the demon in the man's son until the Lord himself came around. And the man complained to him, saying, "I brought my son to your disciples, but they couldn't cast it out." What it means at that time, or what it meant at that time, is that the disciples by then were not so anointed. Afterwards, when they became anointed, you can see from the Bible the miracles that followed them. So at that time, they were still understanding the Lord. So they had no experience. That is what it means. Not all categories of demons can be handled by every Christian. You can handle the small ones. But as you grow, I've done this over 30 years. But I can tell you, I didn't handle all of them at once. I must be sincere to you. The Lord trusted me. As he trusted me, and he's adding more power. That now, where I am now, I can handle every demon, every principality. Because he has added more anointing, more power. That is how it should be. So, if you are a lazy Christian, and you keep saying that casting out demons is a special gift, then you remain there. Please, it is not good. You need to go up. You need to climb up the stairs. You need to go up on the ladder of the anointing so that you can handle the demons that come your way. As a pastor, you don't have to remain in the same position. If you say God has called you, number one, you shouldn't say it's a special gift. So you call another pastor to come and then come and show some power in your church and go away. That is wrong. Your church people will not like you. They will see you as weak. And truly, I've seen that too. When some people invite me and I go to demonstrate the power of God, some of the pastors even get jealous. You see, if you see the demonstration of God's power, it's good to pray and seek the face of God so that he can anoint you too. It is wrong to be bringing people. I told you the other time that it is wrong as a father that you cannot feed your children, but you want other people to come and do it for you. So number two, firstly, it's wrong. Number two, you don't have to say it is a special gift. That is wrong. You have to grow. Pray more. Don't be lazy. If you are a lazy person, you don't pray fast, you cannot grow in the anointing. Understand that one. Okay, having understood that casting out demons is a sign that we follow Jesus, so every Christian can do it and you grow in it. The next thing I want to talk about today is that, you know, it's about fake prophets and fake deliverance. Fake prophets and fake deliverance. When the Lord said his ministers should cast out demons, he was talking about using the power of the Holy Spirit. If you are on the Lord's side, then the power of the Holy Spirit is in you to cast out demons. But it is very interesting that today, across the world, on television, you see a show of power. They demonstrate the show of authority over demons. But let me show you some things today. You see, without the power of the Holy Spirit, nobody can cast out the demon. Because I let you understand, I let you understood the other time that we have demons and their representatives, and we have Jesus and his ministers. So there's no way someone who represents demons can also cast out demons. There's no way. If you represent demons, you cannot cast out demons, because the Lord Jesus himself said, a kingdom divided cannot stand. So something is happening. That is what I want to show you, what is actually happening. When fake or false prophets seemingly demonstrate the power of God. Number one, if you are not on the side of Jesus, then that demonstration is deception. What you see is deception. It can only deceive ignorance and people who don't understand spiritual things. You see, when you are not on the side of Jesus, you cannot cast out demons. So you have to understand, the demons will get wild and they will not, one, you cannot cast them out. Two, they will not obey you. And number three, they will attack you. That is what happened to a Jewish priest whose name was Sceva. And his children wanted to cast out demons. The demons overpowered them. They got angry, overpowered them, and tore them apart. You see, they wanted to show the young men that if you are not on the side of Jesus and don't have authority, you cannot cast us out. That is what I want to tell you. So understand that one. So there are too much deception going on TV. When they say they are casting out demons, it is actually not so. It is not so at all. What is actually happening when they say they are casting out demons? Let me tell you what is happening. So what is actually happening? Number one, I have let you understood that false prophet cannot cast out demons because they are all together. So what is going on there? It means a false prophet will go for a higher power in the demonic kingdom to deceive people by subduing the small ones in people. If someone comes to me, first, the false prophet sees, so he knows the demon that is coming. When he sees that, let's say, in an animal sense, an ant is living in you, and I have the power of a lizard, then you know the lizard can eat the ant. So I, the lizard, I can easily overpower the ant. But we are all animals. You see, that is how it is. The false prophet can seemingly demonstrate the power, but it is, they are still the same. I call it differently in my book. So read my book and you know how I describe that situation. You see? So they can go for a higher demonic power and suppress the small demons so that the ignorant person can believe that I have also cast in our demons. The higher ones can talk to the small ones to calm down and then humble yourself towards this senior. It's a senior disciplining a junior. That is how it is. That is the first scenario. They don't cast out. Number two, demons are not cast out if a false prophet lays hands on you. Demons are not cast out. Because I told you that a demon cannot cast out demon. He only suppressed it. And number two, he even added more. When a false prophet lays hand on you, I tell you, if you know what it means, you will be extremely careful as to who you allow to lay hands on you. They actually add more demons. Another set of demons came in. So they will aggravate your situation. That is how it is. Number three. Because they say they are casting out demons, but it is deception. The deception is this. If I say I have power over demons, why am I using something else? The false prophets use something else to suppress the demons. Some of them pour water on people. Some of them even pour the water on their feet. Now, if you say you are powerful, why are you using water to suppress a demon? It means there is something in the water that is bringing the small demon down. Yes. That is why you see. So any church you go to, that you see the pastor, even the prophet, or today their titles, if he calls himself an apostle, doctor, and he's sprinkling water on people, please run away. This is one of the demonic churches. I'm showing you, I'm talking about demonic operations and fake show of power. If I have power over demons, I will not pour water on people for demons to go down, to obey me. What it means actually that if the water comes from the sea, and mami water or mama water power is in it, that power can have the capacity to bring some young demon down. That is why I'm pouring water on people for you to see manifestation. So that is the secret. Number two, why am I saying drink this before something will happen? It is not biblical that if somebody is sick, he should drink oil. The Bible actually says that we should rub oil on sick people. It didn't say we should let them drink. The oil you are drinking, if you know what is inside, you will run away. They have confessed that they have added some mortuary water, water from dead bodies, is in it. So that they will give it to you. I don't know if they recite some words and some powers are in the oil, and it will suppress the demon. So be careful. Be very, very careful. Why am I pouring oil in your mouth for a manifestation to happen? Some of them will say, get this handkerchief. And when you put this handkerchief, they will quote the scripture and use the scenario that Apostle Paul's handkerchiefs and the apostles' aprons were healing the sick and doing miracles. They were genuine apostles. But if you are not genuine, the handkerchief has something in it. Some of them sell calendars, so they have a way of saying it's a direction from God. It's funny. Please be very careful. Be very, very careful that you don't take this as deliverance. They actually added more. I've prayed for many people who thought they were free, but actually they added more. So that is how it is. If you say you are very powerful, you don't use those things to cast out demons. And the next thing that can happen also is that when the higher demons suppresses, the higher demons suppress the small ones, then the small ones will calm down. If it is the television program, I will calm down. The demon in you will calm down for the show to go on. So you feel better, and I will let people see that, oh, I prayed, I laid hands, and it's better. What you don't know sometimes is that after 6 months or after some time, the same demon that was there, that was suppressed, will pop up, and most of the people are killed. And that one you didn't hear on the TV. That one didn't come. So check it out and be very, very careful. So that is what happens too. They calm down. They calm down for the bigger one to act. So that it will be a show for you to see that the prophet is very powerful. But at the back of the door, something else happened. That is another deception. The next thing that happens also is that when they see, I told you that, when they see that you have a very big demon inside you, a principality that they cannot cast out, that what you have inside you is bigger than what is in them. This is what they will never do. Leave her, leave her. Some of the demons inside the people will be wild. Either he will not pray for you, he will not come near you, he will not come to where you are, or if the person manifests and comes in front, you will hear the false prophet saying, leave this one, leave her. If you say you are powerful, why don't you go there? Many of the higher demons will say, when they see us in the bigger one, in the small ones, they are afraid. They will know that this one I cannot cast out. So they will say, leave it. So these are some of the tricks that go on when you see a false prophet on TV saying he's casting out demons. Actually, He didn't cast out anything. I'm speaking from experience. So be very careful, and then you don't say that, oh, I saw them also casting out demons. If you are not truly called by God, you cannot cast out any demon because they will not obey you, except these things I've talked about. So please, if you say God called you, then fast and pray. Go for the authority in Jesus. I don't need any water. I don't pour water on anybody. I don't pour water on anybody to cast out any demon. I speak. The power is in my mouth. I speak. In action power, we don't sell anything. So I warn people, any church you go to that the pastor is using certain things, handkerchiefs, oils, water, pouring water on people. I don't care if he calls himself an archbishop or what. If you pour water on people for some manifestation to take place, take it from me. I'm speaking from the Spirit of God. That man is false. Don't follow him. If he said he was anointed, if he said he is anointed, let him speak the word. And there are certain factors also to check if he's from God. So these are the things I want you to understand. It will help you. And may God open your eyes so that you don't take the fake demonstration of power of false prophets as casting out demons. Casting out demons can only be done by true servants of God who are anointed by the Holy Spirit. May God bless you. May he open your eyes so that you will not fall a victim. I will see you next time. God bless you. I don't want you to go to hell, but be in heaven. In Jesus' name. Bye-bye.
Thank you for watching this video. I really hope you have been enlightened. To hear more, you may subscribe to this channel and click the notification bell to see more videos. Pastor Kukudatsi has written a very informative book called How Demons Operate. Grab yourself a copy to know how they operate and know how to liberate yourself from demonic oppression. To stay in contact with us, you can reach us through these details. God bless you.